Hi, and welcome to Deduce. Deduce is an amazing new web application for researchers in all fields working with qualitative data, and particularly those that are trying to integrate qualitative and quantitative data together in the same project. Some of the kinds of data that we'll see in Deduce are the stories that people give us in interviews or in responses to particular survey questions. This one has some images as prompts in a study of hotel decision making. We also have information about those people. These are the demographics and quantitative data that we know about them, the more objective types of facts. We also have our code system, or tags, that we'll use to mark up text inside of these documents so that we can go in and search for those themes that are particularly meaningful. And finally, Deduce has a variety of great data visualizations that help you expose patterns hidden inside of your data and then allow you to drill in so that you can get closer to the rich, deep meaning that sits behind these data visualizations. Click on that bubble, and we can look at the qualitative data that sits behind the visualization itself. But before I go any further, let me back up and tell you a little bit about what inspired us to create Deduce in the first place. I'm Dr. Eli Lieber. I've been working in the field of qualitative and mixed methods research for over 15 years, the last 11 with Tom Weisner at UCLA Center for Culture and Health. We found out a long time ago that there weren't any tools to help us manage and analyze the kinds of data that we were collecting in our research. So we started working on solutions. Those solutions have evolved over the last 10 years, and we're really excited to share the work that we've done with you. To start with, I'd like to say a little bit more about mixed methods research in general. Progressive thinkers know that the wider the variety of tools and approaches we can bring together on a research problem, the more likely we are to come up with effective and efficient solutions. We also know that all methods have flaws. So by blending together different methods depending on the demands of a particular problem, the more likely we are to avoid the pitfalls and weaknesses of some methods and capitalize on the strengths of all the methods that we bring together to solve our research problems. That's a win-win. So let's talk about a real-world problem where Deduce was employed to quickly come up with some great answers to a research problem. The situation is this. Market researchers are trying to figure out the best way to advertise for a new concept hotel in Las Vegas. Quantitative data are great at answering questions like what kind and how many. So if we were going to approach this problem from a quantitative perspective, we'd go out and find out things about our participants like gender, their age group, their income level. We might also ask them to fill out questionnaires and give us ratings on scales, like when you're making a hotel decision, how important is it to you on a scale of 1 to 10 of cleanliness, cost, or location? Then what do we do with these data? We can analyze them one variable at a time. So for example, age group. What percentage of our population fell into each of three age group categories? We can do bivariate relationships. Look at, for example, males and females and break those out across age groups and look at the relative number of males and females in each of the particular age groups. Or we can do multivariate analysis. So here again, we have our males and our females for our different age groups, and we're looking at the average importance of location for those people when they're making their decisions about a hotel choice. But what if we really don't know the kinds of questions that we should be asking on these scales? Qualitative data are much better at getting at the why and how kinds of information. And to get this kind of information, we really need to talk to people, to look at people, so that we can understand how culture, how emotion, how people's value systems influences their decisions and their behavior. A classic example of qualitative data are stories. When people communicate their experiences through stories, they do so in natural language, connecting the ideas together in the subjective ways that they really experience those things in real life. These are the kinds of things that we really can't capture with quantitative data. So these stories often come from interviews with individuals, notes that we might write about observations, videotape, audio tape. And these kinds of data really tap into the complexity and richness of the way that people live their lives in real situations. So in the hotel study, we asked people to simply tell us stories about the last time that they made a decision about a hotel in Las Vegas. So we collected all of these stories, and then we searched for the themes that came out on a consistent way that really helped us understand why people were making their decisions. So what do we do with these hotel stories? We go looking for themes that come out on a consistent basis and help us understand why people were making the decisions that they did. So we found consistently that luxury, sophistication, and intimacy kept coming up in these stories. And so what do we do next? We go looking through the stories for examples of text that fit each of those particular themes. So I'll use red for luxury and say, I see something related to luxury here and there in that particular paragraph. And then I go looking for sophistication. And I might see also, oh, sophistication also showed up in this paragraph as well and down here. Something else that we can do with qualitative data is overlay a weighting system onto when those particular codes were applied. So for example, people might be talking about luxury, but it might be more or less important to them. So if we use a 1 to 10 weighting scale of importance, we can apply weights alongside the codes that we apply. Here somebody's talking about luxury, but maybe they're telling us that it's not particularly important to them. So we'll give that a 2. Down here, again, a relatively low weighting. Sophistication, however, is really important to this individual. So we'll give them higher rating for what they said here. Maybe that's an 8. And here they talked about it again, but not so much importance. So we'll give it a 5. So what did qualitative researchers do in the past? They were very clever about how they approached their problems. They would use color schemes, squiggly lines under text. They'd write memos out into the margins of their paper. And they collected piles and piles of paper. And then when the analysis stage came out, literally, people would take the papers and lay them out on the floor, organized by sex, by age group, by other kinds of dimensions, looking for patterns that would really help them understand how these themes were fitting together to understand the research problem at hand. And though we really wanted to work in teams to come up with more objective and valid interpretations of our data, with all the work that we'd done with this paper, it was really, really difficult without any tools to share this information in any kind of an efficient way. And so the teamwork piece really changed the landscape. As people started working in teams, they increasingly crossed methodological boundaries. And more people were working with people from one discipline and another discipline together on research problems, naturally trying to bring together their methodological traditions and the kinds of data that they were collecting in their research. So that's where mixed methods research really took off, trying to bring together all of the richness and complexity that people communicate in stories and all of the quantitative facts that we collect from our populations. So in market research, we really want to narrow in a particular target group so we can develop advertising that's sent just out to them. From the stories, we can pull from the richness and complexity of the language that people in that segment are using to develop messages that really resonate with that particular population. So Deduce was designed to take advantage of today's internet-based technologies to make this type of research fast, efficient, collaborative, and exposing meaningful patterns in your research that would have been impossible before, all helping people find the answers they're looking for as quickly as possible. Great research made easy. Now that we know how cumbersome this research was in the past, let's take a look at how Deduce made this research project really easy. So here we are with our hotel data inside of Deduce. We can see we've got our themes already built out here in our code or tag system. We've uploaded all of our demographic and scale data. And here are some of the documents. So let me briefly show you how to import a document into Deduce. It's very simple. Just go ahead and click on Import Documents. You can also import batches of documents at the same time. Select the document that you want to bring into the project. Go ahead and submit that. And then we're presented with the document. The first thing I want to do is I want to click on my Descriptors tab and attach that to the person that provided these data. That way everything we do with the qualitative data is linked to all of the quantitative data that we have about that individual. Then I'm going to go through my document looking for content that's associated with the particular themes of interest in our study. So let's see. Interviewer asks about the decisions the last time somebody made a visit to a hotel in Las Vegas. This person says he and his wife look for being pampered, and they say quality of service and luxury are really important to them. I'm going to go ahead and create an excerpt out of that. Luxury and service. That seemed to be particularly important, so we'll give a weight of 8 out of 10 on that particular tag. Down here they're talking about sophistication. They want to see a classy, well-mannered clientele. So we'll go ahead and create another excerpt. Tag that with sophistication. Give that a 7. Okay, so once we've gone through all of our documents looking for themes, this is where the fun really begins. Let's say that our deliverable is an analysis and recommendations for advertising for hotels in Las Vegas broken up by particular age groups. Perfect plot and deduce to get to that information is our code weight descriptor bubble plot. So I'm going to go ahead and select those tags that were particularly important in our study: sophistication, intimacy, and luxury. We're going to break that out by age group. So what we see in this bubble is that for the 50 plus members of our sample, when they spoke about sophistication, that's the x-axis, and intimacy, the y-axis, they spoke about these dimensions as particularly important in their decision. The size of the bubble itself is the average weight assigned when we use the luxury tag, and they sort of sit in the middle of the population for that one. So what do I want to do next? I can export this plot, pop it into a PowerPoint presentation ready to go, and I'm going to use this bubble to drill into the qualitative data that sits behind the visualization. Here's the content that we're going to want to draw on so that when we develop our messaging, we speak to this population in a way that really resonates with them. I can export these, present them to my client, but even better, I might want to use Deduce Live so that I can work with my client and interact with them, doing the analysis live and help them see what's sitting behind the visualizations that have exposed important patterns in our data. I hope this brief introduction has helped you appreciate the value of mixed methods research and how the deduced design, features, and cost facilitate efficient and effective work in your research. We've got a number of other videos on our website that show you how to get the best out of deduce, so we'll hope you check those out soon and that we'll be hearing from you.